Good afternoon and welcome to The Eyes of Texas is a talk show. I'm your host, Jordan Newman. I'm back with Arjon, Andie, and a special guest, Motz. Introduce yourself, Motz. How you doing?
Hi, I'm Motz. I'm a second year electrical engineering student. I work with Jordan. Ooh. We tutor.
Yeah, so we are both tutors for Intro to Circuits, EE302. And for those of you who don't know, that's actually really cool that the School of Engineering has free walk-in tutoring for a lot of engineering courses at the EER. It's pretty easy to find that information if you Google Cockrell Engineering for anyone out there who needs some help. Let's see, what's some news? We need a news. The water crisis.
I need some milk.
That's we all need to be drinking milk now.
Who
instead
needs
of water
when you have vodka?
Who needs to boil?
Oh, yeah.
Who needs to boil water when you have milk?
That vitamin D, son. That vitamin D.
That sunny D.
It's like I told you I was going to Dallas for an interview this weekend. I'm really just doing it to get water.
Dude, you better bring back so much water.
I'm bring
like the
so
whole apartment's
water.
Gonna be filled with water.
New furniture.
You walk in and like we're gonna have a couch of water bottles.
Furniture made out.
It's crazy how this is happening though. 2 weeks of no clean water?
Yeah.
Ah.
I don't know how I'm gonna do it, man. Like every time I shower I'm afraid like I'm gonna die.
Yeah. I feel that.
Yeah, I accidentally ingested some water in the shower. I didn't want to think about it. I was like,
no,
ah,
this morning I woke up. I was super zoned out. I was super out of it. I got my toothbrush. I turned on the faucet.
No!
I was like, wait, there's no clean water. So I had to throw it out and then go get
the
my
toothbrush?
New. And then, yeah. And then I threw it out and then I just went to go get my new one.
It probably wouldn't kill you.
I know, but like.
Probably.
I don't know, man.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
Killed me.
Like,
you can't be. You
didn't
can't
realize, so they drunk like an entire bottle of it.
Bruv.
What?
Bruv.
Their stomach was like upset the whole day.
Oh, no.
Nah, man. I can't
and
do that.
And they're like burping in class just nonstop.
See, we don't need that. We don't need that silt.
That's so tragic.
Yeah, they found something in the water, most definitely.
Didn't they say, weren't they saying that last week it was even contaminated?
Oh, yeah.
Well, last week they were just saying last week that they can't filter it correctly, and so it's better to avoid tap water. And
hey,
then, like, 2 days ago, they were like, oh, it's mandatory now, because now there's something in the water.
Definitely.
Yeah, we waited a whole week to tell you that you couldn't drink water.
The conspiracies.
Oh, yeah, I messed up on this. I wonder how much it's, like, costing all this stuff as well.
The
oh, God,
entire city of Austin.
Yep.
Dang.
Like, I went to Target the other day to get some water, and, like, I got nothing because all the water's gone.
It's scary. All the plastic bottle usage, our environment.
Like, people are saying, hey, let's ban plastic straws, but oh no, let's get all the water bottles.
And now here we are doing it in our apartment.
I know.
The plastic straws, I don't think that actually helped at all.
Like, no.
I'm pretty sure. Yeah. Just completely useless.
I mean,
yeah, probably.
This is what we should do. I have a good plan on how we can get through this water crisis.
Mm-hmm.
And this
all
is
die.
Really this. No, no, no.
Okay.
This is really going to work out. And this is why. This is my grade A plan on how we can avoid the water crisis. We get Bikini Bottom
and
we push it somewhere else,
dude.
Bro.
Nice idea.
It can work, guys. It
can
work.
We've got
it. It can work. We got this.
I saw a meme. It was like, just take all the silt and push it somewhere else.
What is life?
Oh, goodness. I've just been boiling water.
You're a smart person.
Yeah,
you're doing it the
same
smart
here.
Way.
Because, like, no, my theater history professor, he said that he boiled the water, too. But then, like, there was, like, this film on top of the water.
Oh, no.
So that's why I'm not trusting
that's
the boiling
bad.
It's because you gotta
I've
boil
not seen
it.
Any of that, yeah.
Yeah, you gotta boil
like,
it and then filter
he just,
it out.
He just told us to invest in a filter.
Mm.
Yeah. Seems smart.
Scary.
It's like, the worst time for it to happen, too. If this happened next week or the week after, I'd be like, wouldn't faze me at all, but it's just one extra thing to worry about on, like, the worst week
Dude,
ever.
It's
the worst week of UT
history.
All the
college students who asked to die, like, they're just answering our prayers by this, you know?
I don't know what's up with it. Motz, have you had a bad week in the last week? Like, for assignments and exams and such?
No.
You are like the first person I've spoken to in the last 9 days who's not just dying this week.
How do
I
you
got
deal
reborn
it?
Today. I'm super
hey.
Excited.
I'm going to get reborn tonight.
Nice.
Yeah.
Second coming.
I'm going to get That's like I don't
can't
really
say that here.
I don't really get to take a breath until Halloween, but I'm looking forward to it.
Nice.
The title. Of your next movie. Got it.
Title of your next movie. The Second Coming.
Was an echoey table slap.
That was nice. Knee slap.
Oh, goodness.
Guys, let's just appreciate that we're alive and we're
exactly.
here.
Hey, positivity, people. Like, positivity.
Like, we're filled with so much negativity sometimes. Honestly. We don't appreciate the positive sides of things.
Yeah.
Like, we're here, we're alive, we're happy.
We exist at the same time as the Marvel Cinematic Universe.
We have a roof over our head. We have food to eat.
We have superhero.
We have loved ones. We have people who love us and that we love, too. So it's like, it's not that bad, you know?
It's not
like,
bad.
It could be worse.
We could be... Okay, I'm not going to say it.
What? Say it.
We could be living third world country.
Bruv.
We could be born with our last name Trump. You know, we could.
Oh, yeah. I feel like living.
No, it's Drump.
Drump.
Drump. Drump. Because Ancestry pulled up.
Yeah, I remember that whole thing.
That one of his ancestors used to be Drumpf, and he changed it.
It's like a John Oliver thing, right?
Yeah, John Oliver. Hashtag make Donald Drumpf again.
That didn't really work.
I loved that.
We should bring it back.
Guys, I have an idea.
I've been having this idea for a while.
You're having a lot of ideas today.
Wow, Arjon. It's because
it's because this really motivational guy came to my last class,
and like, so that's why you're like,
he calls him sophisticated.
No, I made a comment like from a quote from his book, and I paraphrased it into my own words, and he was like, wow. That's really good. You are really sophisticated.
Wow.
I should have thought of that when
I
was writing this book.
And
immediately I was like, damn, you know, like, I'd be like that sometimes. So,
but it was great.
It was amazing. I needed
that's
that.
That's fantastic.
Yeah. No, I needed that. That reborned me.
My horoscope said, like, I would have, like, a profound person speak to me. And I think, like, no one was as profound as that guy, literally asking us, like, our lives as artists.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like,
and basically
he gets
being human.
It. Like, it's okay to say no sometimes.
And to suffer.
And to be
and
weird.
And to suffer. It's okay to be falling apart at the seams.
Yeah, because
Jordan?
It's okay to fail.
I am.
It is okay to fail, and you will learn that
and
as
today,
life goes on.
And today, I'm pretty sure I did.
It's okay.
I had a number theory exam earlier today, and it was horrifying. That was like,
do you guys remember the Harlem Shake?
Oh yeah, I love that.
That is so random.
I know.
I love that. I have no
it's
idea
like,
where you got that from.
I don't know.
I
okay,
just,
I'm sitting this one out.
I was just
gonna
thinking
leave.
About it. Because this song all of a sudden got stuck in my head.
Oh,
and I don't
know.
I thought you were sitting this one out.
Sorry, I just thought of the song.
The song randomly popped into your head.
Yeah, it just randomly popped in my head. Like, I was talking about motivation, and then that song popped in my head, so I guess that's the song of motivation.
It's
those poor listeners
song.
Are just, like, having...
The four listeners out there.
Yeah, our dedicated following of... Probably
Damn.
Four or five listeners.
That
like,
was an
Arjon
eighth grade.
What did I do, bruv?
You set the seed in the mind.
I set my bar low.
I love it. I had probably more to do than like everyone this week.
Bet.
Oh yeah,
and
you did.
Still randomly found time to watch 3 hours of the new CW shows.
Oh,
wait, 3 hours?
Bro.
Yeah, because I watched Legends, Flash, and Arrow.
I don't.
Legends.
For me, it's more of
no
Legends,
one
Flash,
Legends.
And Supernatural.
Supernatural.
Okay, Legends had some awesome references in it.
No.
Yeah, I gotta tell you this. So Legends had some... Do you watch it at all? Have you seen any of it?
No, I haven't seen it.
Okay. Legends, for anyone who doesn't know, Legends of Tomorrow is kind of a spinoff of The Flash and Arrow on the CW, and it's basically a bunch of supporting characters from both shows get grouped together, and they go time traveling, and they go
Was
adventuring.
Was it Robbie in it? Heatwave.
But no, he's not in it.
He was.
No,
was.
Jax was in it.
No, it was Robbie.
No, Robbie was never in it.
Yeah, it was.
No, it definitely was.
I thought Robbie would be in it.
He died.
I was like avoiding saying it, and it's just
let's
he died.
Let's just spoil it at this point.
He died before that show started.
Season 1 of The Flash.
Really?
Spoiler of season 1 of The Flash. The Reverse Flash kills the Flash's mom, if you guys don't know, so spoiler alert.
Yeah.
Wow.
So with Legends, season 1 was like kind of bad because it was taking itself too seriously. But then in season two, it had just an awesome story. But in season three, it started becoming a parody of itself because it's become aware of how dumb the concept is. And I love that. But now in season four, they had like a big deal.
This is season three, isn't it?
No, they're now in season four.
What was season three about?
No, this is season three.
Season three was the anachronisms.
But that was season two, wasn't it?
No, season two was Reverse Flash and Malcolm Merlyn.
How are we already in season four of this show?
In season two, Malcolm Merlyn, Damian Dark, and the Reverse Flash team up, and they're the villain for season two of Legends. It's actually great.
So, like, recycled characters become the villains for Legends?
But they're good villains.
They're not recycled, I think.
I mean, at this point, their story arcs are over, so they're recycled. They're just trying to milk it at this point.
But they're really cool.
Damian Dark's story ended on Arrow. Reverse Flash's story ended on Flash.
No, and it definitely did not. I think the Reverse Flash's story still has life in it, for
sure.
Yeah,
like, I don't think his story ever ends, especially based on who he's in the comics.
I mean, right now it has ended, because they haven't brushed light on him in a long time.
Well, anyway, season two is worth watching, because the villains are amazing. But then in season three, it kind of becomes a parody of itself, and they're, like, tracking down anachronisms and everything. But then at the end of season three, they wind up like there's like they fight a demon or something and they break
Malice or whatever.
You've seen that, right?
Did you watch the
first episode this week?
I just seen season three.
But so they opened like the gateway between our world and the mystical world, and they've got like John Constantine, who's now a series regular.
Yes. What? So they brought him back?
Yeah, they brought him back. He's now a series regular on Legends for season four. And what's great is that at the beginning of this episode, they made so many meta references that Sarah walks in and all the Legends are kind of like sitting around bored, and they're just saying, you know, it's just all kind of the same thing. We've just been tracking down anachronisms for like 4 years. We want to do, like, where are all these mystical creatures Constantine promised us we'd be fighting? And then she says, wait. We are all happy that there was only one dragon, right? And then I think Rey says...
That's the end of season three.
Yeah, but then Rey says, well, it would be good for our ratings. And everyone kind of looks at him and says, what ratings?
Meta.
And he says, oh, well, the Time Bureau, they rate their employees, and we don't do very well. And he goes, it's okay, though. We've got a few dedicated fans.
That's definitely a Game of Thrones reference.
He says, we've got a few dedicated fans, and it would be good. And then at some point, they were... Because in that episode, they fight, like, a demon unicorn. Or something, I don't know. They fight like some crazy demon unicorn, and it was awesome. But towards the end, they're saying, oh, this is going to be, Ray says again, this is going to be great for our ratings. People love the supernatural. And it was like, I cannot believe that he directly referenced supernatural.
I loved the supernatural.
Yeah, it's like, of course, in the context of the show, he just means it is like supernatural stuff, the supernatural, but it's like, he's talking about the show Supernatural, and that was very clever.
That's such a great show.
But so Legends has really grown on me because it's become very self-aware and very self-referential.
Supernatural's so great. Let's talk about Supernatural.
Supernatural's
now. But I've only
the
seen
best.
Season one.
Let's forget.
I've
let's
never seen
let's
it.
Let's forget about the Legends.
I've
let's,
seen let's talk all about 14 one seasons. Season.
Let's talk about more important things like Supernatural.
I've watched one
Sam
season
and Dean.
Of Supernatural.
Sam and Dean. Saving people, hunting things.
It was great, the family but business. I've only watched family one business. Season.
You know what, Jordan? You need to get on that.
Well, yeah. That is a lot of time dedication.
Okay, don't say that. Do not say that. That you finished Brooklyn Nine-Nine in a week.
That is a lot of time dedication.
That
is 5 seasons of 20-minute episodes.
You know, you can't judge me.
You finished, what else did you finish?
That is less
you
than finished, a sixth of the time of Supernatural.
How long did it take you to finish Gotham?
Well, I watched it as it came out.
Oof.
You can watch Supernatural as it comes out.
But I'm 13 years behind.
Don't worry, I'll pull you in those 13 years. You didn't really miss much.
You didn't really miss much, so here's where we're at.
So, like, here's the thing. Okay, how long did it take you to finish, what's another long show that you watch?
I've never binged a long show. Like, I pretty much, everything I watch, I pretty much got into when it came out. So I've pretty much been following everything from the beginning. Like, Arrow, I discovered right as season two was starting. So I binged season one in, like, a couple weeks. And then I just watched season two as it came out. And then now I've followed all of these CW shows as they come out.
Well, treat Supernatural as if it's barely coming out, you know? Watch an episode of
I'll fill you in from 2005 up to now.
Damn, that's a lot of years.
I know.
Season one is very good, though. I will admit that it's a good show.
I wasn't about it, season one. Not gonna lie. Yeah, no, it took me a while to really get into it, but
really?
Once season three
I enjoyed
hit,
season one. I'm told that the vibe really changes later.
Just think about it. Supernatural's been going on for 13 years.
Yeah.
14.
Wow. Not 13, bro.
Going on 14.
2005 up to now.
They're going to have their 200th episode already, bro.
Oh, my goodness.
Dang, that's long, bro.
Yeah,
but yeah, it is TV season, that's for sure.
No, it changes a lot.
It's TV season.
It changes a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, if they weren't doing Supernatural and if it ended early, Jensen Ackles would have played Captain America.
Oh, yeah, he definitely
would
have.
Oh, my goodness.
But he turned it down because of Supernatural.
That's probably for the best, because Chris Evans is...
I think Jensen Ackles
would not have been
Captain
as good
Ackles,
as Chris Evans.
Nah, Jensen
if
Ackles,
anything, or Green
not
Lantern.
Have done it as well.
Green Lantern, yeah.
Green Lantern, yes.
Chris
Captain
Evans
America,
would make a good
no.
Green Lantern. But
nah,
like,
I don't see it.
Nah,
I see it.
Though.
Evans is like.
Will we ever get a good adaptation of Green Lantern?
No,
maybe. Unless it's like fan filmed.
Fan, really?
They referenced it in The Flash that one time.
Oh yeah, they did.
Oh yeah.
Oh, there was one in a flat. They messed
in Arrow.
In Arrow also. There was a flashback where Oliver was talking to Amanda Waller,
and he's like in Coast City.
And he's in, and then you see a guy wearing a jacket that says Jordan.
Mm.
And so that was pretty cool.
Well, what was the like love interest like? Season 2 for Flash.
Patty Spivot?
Yeah, wasn't it like hinted that her dad was like the Green Lantern or something?
What? Where? Where?
No,
who is this?
No, because she's the one that told him like the story of like how her dad like disappeared or something.
Oh no, her dad was killed in the bank robbery.
Really?
I just immediately remember everything about the show.
That's a little dark, bruv.
Yeah, no, but I remember because it was a big deal for her characterization that she keeps telling the story about how her dad died.
Right.
And that's why she wanted to be...
That she keeps telling the story.
Well, she tells it twice in the season, so it's memorable. To two different characters. I miss Patty's Spivet.
Me too.
She's a great character.
Yeah,
she was great.
Get Iris out of here.
Dude, right? Like,
I don't like Iris.
I don't like Iris. Like, it's not Team Iris. It's Team Flash.
Well,
like, get out of there.
I remember the one, I can't believe you do that, Barry. I can't believe you lead me. He went to go save the world. So, like...
And then when he comes back from the Speed Force, she's all like, we gotta get back to work. It's not like I missed you or anything.
What?
Oh,
like,
man.
I'm out of here.
Is that allowed?
She does nothing on the team.
She does nothing. She just yells at them and expects them to do
everything.
At least
like that she's doing like her journalism again.
Okay, and like what really grinded my gears was
okay, Peter.
Old man.
What really grinded my gears is that like Cisco in the beginning of episode one, like how he's super mopey and how he's super.
I loved it. I thought he was great.
No, dude, like I get it that you just broke up, but you got work to do. You're a hero.
Dude, he needed some time.
I thought it made for some funny moments. Yeah.
He was great as mopey Cisco, and we're like Barry tries to cheer him up by being like, hey Cisco, so what should we call this metahuman who can create blocks out of, you know, condensed air? And he goes, I don't know, block. And he just walks away, and it was like, oh my god, that's poor Cisco.
Nah, son.
I don't know. Block.
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 I love when he names Gridlock, because like he hears, because Nora calls the character, this is like if anyone doesn't watch The Flash, they're hopelessly lost by this point. But Nora mentions Gridlock, and he's like, oh, Gridlock, the future's just full of great names, huh? He's like annoyed, but then later he comes talking about how Gridlock can like arrest, you know, can like take away kinetic energy or something, and he says, wow, I'd hate to be caught in that Gridlock. He goes, Gridlock! Gridlock! I named Gridlock! And so he just... I love it.
I'm really excited to see where the season goes.
I'm very excited.
It's a lot of future.
Especially after episode 3.
Right.
Ooh, episode 3, which you have not watched.
How about we
not? Do you know what it's titled?
How about we not?
Do you know what it's titled?
How about we stop? No.
No, but like it's the title.
No.
I want to know
the title of the episode.
I will leave right now.
It's titled The Death of Vibe. Season
really?
5, episode 3,
bye,
The Death of Vibe.
I bet I'm out. Peace, guys.
Oh, man.
Bye.
They titled the episode The Death of Vibe.
I'm very cautious, because these last two seasons have left me very disappointed in The Flash.
Oh, mm-hmm.
Season 3 was bad. I actually really enjoyed Season 4. I don't understand everyone hating Season 4. Everyone hates it.
It's because it was super dragged on with DeVoe and everything.
It seems very dragged on.
Season 1 was good. Season 2 was dragged on. Season 3 was dragged on. Season 4 was dragged on.
Yeah, it's just a lot of,
it's filler. It's a lot of drag.
It's a lot of drag. Like,
you could do the, all the arcs could be done in like 8 episodes, but they do 23 like 50 minute episodes.
By the end of the episode, they're like season 3, and like, spoiler alert, Iris dies. Iris is not gonna die. Iris is gonna die. She's not gonna die. HR died. Iris is gonna die. Even though HR died. Like, I didn't understand where it was going.
It was crazy.
Yeah. And then, like, Savitar being future Barry Allen because he's a time remnant.
Yeah.
I did not understand.
No, season 3 was bad. Like, I don't even feel bad about randomly spoiling the entire plotline of season 3 because it was like, don't watch it. Nothing good came out of season 3. And you wouldn't really miss anything if you skipped season 3 is the crazy part.
You would.
Yeah.
The only thing you'd miss is Caitlin has superpowers.
Barry going into the Speed Force.
Yeah, like you'd miss that, Barry had to run to the Speed Force to save everyone. It's like, I kind of figured that was going to happen eventually anyway.
Okay, so like there is one line from Flash that I'm still trying to see what it means.
This house is.
You can say. I think you can say this house is bitching on the air. I'm pretty sure you're allowed to say that.
Okay.
I'll just get fired if you can't. It's fine.
I love when Nora comes in and they're like, they ask her. They want to know if she's gonna say that.
I most love about, I actually really liked that joke because for the whole season, it's like the joke wasn't. It was like a self-fulfilling prophecy.
Right.
Because no one was ever going to say that, but now that they've heard it, every time someone walks in, they assume they're going to, like, the pizza delivery guy shows up, he's like, man, this house is, and Joe goes, bitchin', yeah, we know. And he goes, no, I was gonna say hard to find. And it's like, every time someone walks in and says, wow, this house is, he goes, bitchin'? And he goes, no, old.
I wonder who's gonna be the
I feel like someone's gotta say
it. I don't
it.
Think anyone's ever gonna say it.
Really?
I think the joke was just that it became a self-fulfilling prophecy that now Joe has said
I feel like someone's gonna say it. I feel like someone. Okay, so let's just talk about when Batman's gonna be introduced into the Arrowverse.
And what?
Because Bruce Wayne was already dropped.
By Jensen Ackles, please.
Oh, that would be so amazing.
No, they're doing season 14, man.
I know Jensen has
Stephen
no time.
He'd have time to do like the crossover, like one episode.
He didn't know.
Well, actually, they're lowering the episodes of Supernatural.
What?
Yeah, they're instead.
Oh, so he has time. Interesting.
There's gonna be only like 2019.
Yeah, Stephen Amell recently blew everyone's minds on Twitter. It was like, it was deliberately just a mean tease because apparently Jensen Ackles was spotted on the set of the crossover episode of all of these CW superhero shows. And Stephen Amell tweeted and he said, I just want to crush this rumor now before it gets started. Jensen Ackles was there because he's Grant Gustin's, you know, biggest fan. He goes, not because he's playing Batman, I promise. He was like, why would you even bring up Batman if you didn't want to freak me out?
I feel like Jensen Ackles is going to be Batman. If he is,
I will cry.
I will cry.
I will just cry.
He's the old, like, even like
that
he
voice,
even, that voice,
that
deep
voice.
That deep voice he does. Like, he doesn't even have to fake it because that's his voice.
Yeah.
He doesn't have to Christian Bale it because that's his voice.
Christian Bale. Oh my god.
That's
my least favorite Batman voice.
Really?
He doesn't.
Where were the other drug dealers? I told you that I'm your favorite. Where is Rachel? The Joker.
I feel like I have Batman fatigue, though.
What, Batman fatigue?
Yeah.
Maybe.
I have a feeling like he was
like
lightheaded the whole time he was talking. He was just like,
I'm sure he damaged his voice doing that. I'm sure.
I'm
Christian
pretty sure.
Bale damages everything.
Have you seen the College Humor video about how Batman chose his voice?
Yes.
Because it's hilarious. He's like doing all these impressions, and then he finally just blows out his voice and winds up with that one.
Going back to Arrow, can we appreciate that Bruce Wayne name drop?
From a year ago
that he did.
Yeah,
that was amazing.
At the beginning of season 6 of Arrow, there's this plot line where someone has leaked a picture of Oliver in the Arrow suit to the press, and it turns out that it's like this isn't even a real picture. It's like a fake picture. That someone's just trying to call out Oliver. And Oliver walks into City Hall, and everyone's like asking him, "Are you the Green Arrow?" And he says,
"I remember this."
And he says, "You can do anything with Photoshop because you could have put Bruce Wayne's head on that body." And, and then he turns to the advisor and he says, "Has Bruce Wayne left Gotham recently to hang out in Star City?" No.
Is that the first time they mentioned Gotham as well?
Also, yeah, they name dropped Gotham.
Stephen Amell, he was so scared to say that line.
I know.
Because
I
he didn't know what was going to come, because the producers, they didn't green light that line.
Yeah.
And he said it anyway.
What?
Stephen Amell is the best.
He's amazing.
He is really great.
I love
yeah.
Stephen Amell.
Grant Gustin, though, like, Grant Gustin and Stephen Amell, they're my two favorite actors.
And they have great chemistry. Like, I wish if anyone ever gets tired of both of these shows, they should just do, like, a buddy cop spinoff show. It's just the two of them hanging out.
Just the two of us.
Spider Cop and Friend.
Spider Cop?
When Spider Cop gets on the scene. The chief never knows what's coming.
Oh my goodness.
Just two brothers.
Two brothers.
Two brothers. I love it in the morning.
Two brothers, and they have a very special bond, but you don't want to hear about that here.
I think any time that Arrow and Flash are on screen together, it's just amazing.
And then the moon crashes into Earth, and they're running.
This is a Rick and Morty reference.
And,
yes.
And then a Mexican armada shows up.
That explains it, because I've
two
not watched
brothers.
Rick and Morty.
You didn't watch
it's two brothers.
Not,
it's just
it's
called.
Just two brothers.
It's just called two brothers. I'm so hopelessly lost.
It's just called Two Brothers. And they have a very special bond, but you don't want to hear about that here.
Watch
show
it, Jordan.
Is so amazing.
I'll show you like the first episode when you get back.
You'll love it.
Okay.
Oh no, I'll show you the only episode you need to pay attention to in a dimensional cable.
It's a dimensional cable.
And the one where the alien parasites take over.
Rick Potion number 9. That's my favorite one.
No, Rick, what was the one with the alien parasites? What's it called?
That's Total Recall.
Yes, Total Recall. Okay. The two episodes I'm going to show you is Total Recall and Interdimensional Cable.
Yeah.
All right, sounds great.
Cuz it's amazing, dude. It's great.
Okay, so we are, I think I should probably call it a show a little bit early, because I have to catch a bus.
Mr. Poopy Butthole.
Mots may or may not be back next week, depending on availability, and the show may or may not be back next week, depending on how many rules I've broken.
Depending if we die on it with water.
Let's just break all of them right now.
But anyway, so yeah, thank you for listening in. I'll talk to you guys next week, and as always, this should be posted online later today. I say that like I'm not already a week behind on posting last week's episode online, but I'll get around to it, don't worry.
We'll do it.
Alright, thanks for listening. Bye, everyone.
I'm sure I can.
Bye.
Bye.